In this video, we'll share four important tips that will help your Kaiser kids perform on the MAP test. Take your time, read the directions, refer to the text, and have teachers pronounce an unknown word. As mentioned in video two, many sections of the MAP test are untimed. While we don't want Kaiser kids to spend all day testing, we do want students to take their time and make use of breaks that are available to them. I'm not a particularly fast reader, and I frequently like to reread passages to make sure I understand the text. I vividly remember taking tests as a child and watching other kids around me finish their test while I still had several pages to go. Seeing this made me anxious, and I often tried to pick up my pace, even when I didn't need to. Looking back, I'm sure that rushing actually made it more difficult for me to concentrate on what I was doing. Many of our teachers try to think about pacing and estimate how long students might take to complete the test. Our rooms will be physically rearranged for testing anyway, and we've learned it's beneficial to seat students around those who might finish in approximately the same amount of time. Pacing has absolutely nothing to do with how many questions kids will answer correctly, of course, nor do our room arrangements. But if we can remove some of this unnecessary anxiety and encourage kids to take their time, then all students are better off for it. It's also very important for kids to read all directions and be sure they are answering what the question asks. This should go without saying, but every year we see kids miss items that they should get correctly, only because they jumped right into answering and didn't pay enough attention to the directions. This is especially true when students are asked to read a passage and answer questions based on evidence or ideas from the text. Kaiser kids who may already know a lot about a topic can actually be at a disadvantage if they answer questions or provide evidence from their own experiences rather than from the text itself. For example, students who play soccer may have insightful answers after reading a story about soccer, but these answers can be wrong if the ideas didn't come from the text itself. We practice this all year, but it's probably worth mentioning to your child as well. Our last tip is an important one, but one that some of our students don't often take advantage of. Teachers who are monitoring testing are allowed to pronounce one word in each sentence for a student, but only if the student asks for this assistance. We cannot define the word, and we can't provide any additional information that might help students with their answers, but sometimes just hearing the word can be helpful for kids. Students should not hesitate to ask teachers to pronounce a word that is unknown or unfamiliar. Our clue word for this video is best. Watch the last two clips for your last two words.